award itself was made by the regime and is only there to protect the interests of the regime. The election is fake. People want change. People are. However, the government have been telling the people that if we are bringing economic development, if we bring economic development, it's okay. This is a developmental state, so that democracy would come later. Our democracy is always young. Even the last 10 years, 20 years, it has been saying that our democracy is young. We will change things after. It takes time. However, people want change, and we are witnessing that a regime without democracy, of authoritarian development, is not sustainable. Development without democracy, development without respect of human rights, is not sustainable. I mean, even though that government follows that a developmental state policy, which says if we are bringing development, which is a lie, because which does not represent, maybe few have been developed or few have become millionaires, however, it's not across the board. So people are getting impoverished, people are getting poorer and poorer, therefore people want change in that country. And this is not the first time people wanted, people protested in that country. People have been protesting, but it's not like this time.
I will give the last word to you in the minute that we've got left. How do you see this playing out? Do you feel that things may get worse before they get better, unless these underlying sources of friction and frustration that you talked about are addressed?
Yeah, I just want to make a point in terms of the government's recent line about Egyptian and Eritrean meddling. And I think this is one of the sort of latest in a series of blame games by the Ethiopian government. Sort of deflects that attention from the internal crisis. This is also a way of actually besmirching and delegitimizing this legitimate grievance of the Oromos and other people. The real hardship, the motivation, is painful suffering and anguish that the Oromos and other people go through is a very real fact. And I don't think Oromos and the rest of the Ethiopian people need Egyptians or Eritreans to tell them why it is important, to remind them that it is time to fight for equality and justice.
That is going to have to be the last word. Thank you to both of you, Awol Alo and Magesa Odo. Thanks very much for being on Inside Story. And thank you for watching. As always, you can see the panel at any time. Just visit our website, aljazeera.com. And for further discussion, go to our Facebook page. Facebook.com/AJInsideStory. You can also join the conversation on Twitter. Our handle is @AJInsideStory. From the Hazard Speaker and the whole team here. Bye for now.